The Himalaya Karakoram range of South Asia has the most glaciers, and that's why it is called the Water Tower of Asia or the Third Pole. But climate change is having an adverse effect on this region too. In such a situation, it is very important to understand the response of water resources that originate from this mountainous region and cater to about a billion people. As part of this effort to create a better understanding, a research team led by Dr. Mohammad Farooq Azam, Assistant Professor, Indian Institute of Technology, Indore, has conducted a comprehensive study. The research, supported by an INSPIRE fellowship from the Department of Science and Technology, identifies gaps in understanding the impact of climate change and outlines possible solutions to address these gaps. The research gathered results from more than 250 research papers to arrive at a more accurate understanding of the links between global warming, precipitation change, and glacier shrinkage. The study shows that the ice and glaciers in the Himalaya Karakoram range are melting rapidly, thereby altering the water supply in rivers like the Indus, Ganga, and Brahmaputra.
Glaciers are a direct indicator of climate change. In the Himalayas, only few glaciers are under observation. In order to understand the impact of climate change on Himalayan glaciers, scientists observe high altitude meteorology, glacier mass balance, change in its glacier ice thickness and dynamics, as well as glacier hydrology. With increasing recent attention of scientific community, the understanding about Himalayan glaciers has increased swiftly. However, this understanding remains poor compared to other mountain ranges of the world.
According to this research paper published in the journal Science under the title Glaciohydrology of the Himalaya Karakoram, total river runoff, glacier melt, and seasonality of flow in these rivers are projected to increase until the 2050s, with some exceptions and large uncertainties. Since the melting glaciers fulfill the water requirements of these rivers, people will be affected when much of the glacier ice mass melts throughout the century and gradually stops supplying the required amount of water. To avoid this scenario, policymakers need to assess the current status and possible future changes of rivers for sustainable water resource management for agriculture, hydropower, drinking water, sanitation, and hazard situations.
Now it is clear that Himalayan glaciers are losing mass, which is consistent with global warming. However, glacier shrinkage rates are not uniform along the Himalayan range because climate varies from one location to other. And in order to understand the impact of climate change on the whole Himalayan range, we need to select more glaciers for observation from different climatic regimes in the Himalaya. And such local studies are also important for the development of large-scale models for future glacier evolution as well as runoff evolution.
The research team has recommended a stepwise strategy to address the identified gaps. This includes an expanded observation network that places fully automatic weather stations on selected glaciers. They also suggest developing comparison projects to examine glacier area and volumes, glacier dynamics, permafrost thaw, and snow and ice sublimation. The next phase recommends the implementation of the knowledge from these studies in detailed models of glacier hydrology to reduce the uncertainty in projections of future change.